we all get Zoom fatigue at some point during the day, but we also have these other distractors that are happening in our lives too. And for many of us who have children at home still, you're dealing with trying to be a parent and trying to do homework and have the kids do Zoom calls and trying to think about what's for dinner. And then you've got the constant interruptions that happen in this new work age that we have. So I think it's really important for us to focus on those two areas, mental wellness, as well as financial health. And I think those two together, you know, sort of round out that person as I go back to that whole person concept to take and reduce the amount of stress that we all have.
The thing that's so important is that we, as leaders and as fellow human beings and colleagues, that we are modeling what we want to see and that we're taking care of ourselves in all areas of wellness, all dimensions of wellness, whether that's our physical wellness, mental, emotional, financial. And it really is about, you know, how do we address each day? That's going to impact how we feel. And of course, we're about looking to create satisfaction in the work that we do. So when we think about business leaders, you know, we have an opportunity to, again, lead by practice, by our behaviors. Everything that we do is a behavior. So the words that we use, the priorities that we make, how we behave with one another, how we treat each other. And then another thing I think is important is making sure that we're listening to our workforce right now.
You've got to model the behavior as a leader to ensure your people are taking time for themselves, they're paying attention to the right things. And, you know, we talk about work-life balance. In this day and age, what we realize is it's truly work-life integration, in which your life and your work, you can't separate the two. And so we have to be conscious and how to understand how do we separate the two when we need to take a break, take a pause, do something physical, get your hormones moving and get your brain thinking very, very differently.
I'm glad we're having the conversation, right? We've got to keep having these conversations because we are shifting the way that we're looking at our workforce. We've probably been headed down this path, and because of the pandemic, it just got accelerated. And in terms of looking at all the dimensions of wellness, it's so important that we are, as employers, as business owners, that we are considering all those elements, and we're, you know, intentionally, actively looking at how do we serve the employees? Because all of us are in our work environments. We want to do good work. We want to have satisfying and productive and equanimous lives. And so, what can we do as employers to support that? And I think that having the conversation and continuing to have those dialogues and listen and iterate as we need to is really important.
This mental toughness is something that we all need as we are dealing with the various pressures that are going on. There's an old saying that, you know, pressure either makes diamonds or bursts pipes. Mm-hmm. So be in the category of making diamonds, I think, is really important.